I've been walking too long.
G'day guys, how you doing? Now today is the big day. Today is what I've been amping up for the past couple of weeks with you guys. It is the start of my 2 month trip. So today I am flying out for the first leg of the trip where I'm going to Ireland. My flight is in a few hours. It is at 3:50. It is now 20 past 11. Dad should be here very soon. We're gonna drive out in probably an hour or so. My bags are packed. Got all the odd jobs done that I need to. I went to the shops this morning. I deposited money. I got a couple of disposable cameras because if any of you guys follow my Instagram story, you will know that I do like my hard copy photos because I don't always like to rely on digital photos because there is something special about like film and hard copy photos. With digital photos, there's something about it where, you know, it's just really like click, 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 click. You can go through all the photos, delete the ones that you don't want. There's no real thought process around it, but when you're using disposables and film, you really have to think about the shot, take your time on it, and you can't filter through them and see what you've taken until developing them. When I'm on the trip and when I'm at a spot, I really have to think about it, take my time, and really choose the shots that I want to. So I think I got 50 photos worth out of two cameras, so I've really got to choose my shots wisely while I'm on the trip. There's gonna be 50 special moments for me to capture, to really remember the trip, to put up on my wall. So there's 50 memories for me to really look on this wall when I get back. So that's gonna be something nice to kind of remember every day when I wake up. So yeah, like I said, just waiting for Dad now. I've got everything packed, done everything. I pretty much did everything yesterday. And because I did everything yesterday, this morning, my body woke me up at 6 o'clock. And you know when you have something big on, like when it's Christmas, when it's your birthday, your body wakes you up really early, like at 6 o'clock, 5 o'clock. Because today my flight's at like 3:50, my body still woke me up at 6 o'clock. So I've been sitting around all day. And because I went to the bank and I went and got the cameras, I only had a couple things to do. So I've been sitting around today listening to music literally for hours. I didn't have jobs on end and rushing around and trying to complete things because my body's like, dude, you gotta get stuff done, wake up early, you gotta get this done, you gotta... No, that was yesterday. I did everything. I got stuff done all week. I was getting it done early so that I could sleep in and get rest and... There's really no logic to my body. It's just... Oh well, I'm excited. I guess it's just too much excitement. Like, I just wanted to get up early just so I could get there early and onto the plane. But yeah, it's gonna be the best time ever. Like, I'm so excited. I'm way too lucky to be experiencing this and like at 18 and to be going on what has been a dream trip. Like, I've been wanting to do this sort of experience since I was probably in year 8. And so to be doing this now, it's amazing. So I'm honestly looking forward to it way too much. So I'm gonna shut up. I'm gonna wait for Dad to get here and get on the road to the airport. So, yay!
We are the music makers, and we are the dreamers of dreams.
That is baggage done. I've got my tickets. Now I've just got to worry about customs. I'm pretty sure I should be sweet for that.
Oh! Oh, beautiful! Have you guys heard this one?
I've got nothing to worry about for there. I've got to wait just a couple hours till departure and then off to Abu Dhabi is where I'm stopping over, then to a small layover for there. So yeah, now it's just the international departures. Suspected, I made it through security fine. So now I've got 50 minutes till we board. So I might grab a bite to eat because I'm starving and I think they only serve afternoon tea and dinner. So I've got a while till we eat on the plane. So I might just, you know, grab a bite to eat, watch some planes take off and land. But that's about it. There's not much to do at the moment here, apart from watch some clouds go by.
Let's get a ham, cheese, and tomato toasty.
Anything else?
Okay.
1,000 years later.
Anything else?
Oh, no.
How you doing, 50 cent?
That's fine.
Ham, cheese, tomato.
And yes, that is a car being loaded into the plane I'm about to get on.
Alright, so dusted off that pretty lukewarm toasted ham, cheese, tomato sandwich, and they're now starting to board. I think they're boarding the, like, the gold class and the premium seaters, but I should be able to start boarding in the next 10 minutes. It's an hour until we actually head off. I think it's about a 10-hour flight. I think that's what my friend said. I didn't actually check how long it was.
Well, aren't you an idiot? If you checked, you'd know that it was 13 hours, not just 10. So enjoy that.
But it's a pretty long flight. It's towards, our first stopover is in Abu Dhabi, and it's only a 4-hour layover. So it's not too long. It should take like an hour to get from one gate to the next when we stop over. But yeah, now they're just starting to board all the premium flyers. So it should be about 15 minutes until everybody else starts boarding. But yeah, so here begins the adventure to Ireland, but it should be like 24 hours until I actually get to Ireland, but yeah, it kicks off the first vlog. Painful 13-hour flight, I have made it to Abu Dhabi, and I think we've got about I think I've got about 30 minutes before we board the flight to Dublin, which is 6 hours.
And if you're wondering about the harsh look, I think it's time for a bit of a story time.
Okay, so yeah, story time. Going through customs, the woman in front of me, she was the one I was sitting with. She went before me, and she was originally from Dublin, I'm pretty sure. So she had an accent already because she was always visiting. So straight away, she only took like 30 seconds to go through. So they straight away just let her through, so they had no problems. And like, no malice against her. She was like the most lovely woman. She was practically like my mum for the trip. We were talking the whole time, and she was like a very lovely woman. We bonded over like every little thing. We were laughing all the time. Yeah, it was just an amazing person. So like, I wasn't angry at her that she went straight through. But when she went through, I thought that I would be the same. Like, I wouldn't have any problem. I thought that the custom people would be fine. And then I got up there, and the woman starts asking me every single damn question. She asks, you know, why am I here? And I just say, hey, you know, I'm visiting a friend. Who's the friend? And as you guys know, the friend is Nina. How do you guys meet? And I said, you know, over the internet. And then like, I just saw like gears kind of switch in her head, and that's when she kind of was trying to find a way. It looked like she was trying to find a way to not let me in. And I knew that I had to find any way I could to just like kind of keep my cool and not screw my chances. She was just asking me every little thing. She's like, you know, how long have you known Nina for? And I'm like, oh, you know, good part of a year, year and a half. What's your relationship with her? And I'm like, you know, we're just good friends. And then she started calling Nina my girlfriend. I'm like, no, Nina's not my girlfriend. She has a girlfriend. She got me to pull out my laptop and connect to the bloody airport Wi-Fi to show her my ticket to America, because she's like, you know, when are you leaving? I'm like, oh, I'm going through to America on the 9th, so I'm only here for a week. And she's like, oh, can you show me your ticket? I'm like, oh, you want me to, I don't have it printed out. Do you want me to show you? Like, she's like, oh, get me an email. I'm like, okay. So I pull out my laptop. I have to like, while like everybody's standing right there looking at me waiting, and I can tell people are getting impatient because we already waited like 10 minutes for another set of people to like go through. She was doing the same thing with another set of people. Pull out my laptop. I have to like, I pulled out my return ticket email, and she's like, yeah, that's fine, but where's your flight to America? And she didn't believe that I was flying to America like when I said I was. And I pulled it up, and there, lo and behold, I'm flying to America in a week on the 9th. You know, she takes ages to look at it. She seems pretty sus. And she then re-asked me, you know, when are you flying to America? And I'm like, the 9th. And she's like, the 9th of what? I'm like, of June?
No shit, Sherlock!
And I wanted to kind of, I didn't give her any attitude, but I really wanted to, like, you dumb fuck, what went out? Like, I said that I'm leaving in a week. It is June right now. I know that it's June. I said, what other month could I be talking about? I'm saying I'm leaving on the 9th. And then she didn't believe, then she started to not believe that Nina was real. And she's like, can you pull out your phone and show me messages between the two of you so I know that she's a real person? So I had to pull out my phone and my iMessages and show text messages between me and Nina. And just, and like, I was not expecting this, because when I went to India, there was nothing. We literally just walked straight through. It was like going home through Australia. There, we just walked through like these bloody like metal detectors, and that was all that customs was. Even like, at least I don't remember them doing anything like that. And it was just, that was it. We were in India, but here it was just like, I wanted to punch that woman. The questions, like, I did not expect that at all. Like, I would expect that from like America, like any like, every little question. But just like, how long are you here for? A week. Okay, who are you here to see? How do you know them? Are they real? What's your relationship with them? How do you meet them? This is while everybody's looking at me, judging me. I can feel their greasy, dirty eyes looking at me, just like looking me up and down, being like, oh, this guy. But I made it through. I kept my cool. Just, I was so close to giving that woman attitude, but I remembered what Dad told me, to just bite my tongue and be respectful. Yes. Look at that view. Lovely. But yeah, now at the moment, just on my way to a part of Ireland called Limerick. Limerick's a couple hours away. And yeah, so Nina and her friends, they wanted to show us around. And then tonight we're going to be driving back to Ennis. That's where Nina lives. And then we're going up to the pub tonight. And yeah, so we're here for the week and then flying out to America. And then I'll be there for the rest of the 2 months. So it's a big trip plan, but I'll let you guys get back to watching the views.
Hello. Yeah.